Have you ever wondered how you can really get a lot of mileage and traction for the podcast shows that you're on to really optimize not only the appearance of the interview that you did, but on the back end, making it go all over the internet? Hi, this is Kathleen Gage with Power Up for Profits and the 100 Club, where we help entrepreneurs find 100 show opportunities in record time. And one of the ways that you can get a lot of traction for what you're doing is to optimize the show notes that the show host will create as a result of you being on the show. Now, what are show notes? Basically, they're notes about the episode that you were on that a podcast host will put on a website that is specific to the podcast show that they have. And each episode has their own unique show notes. Now, not every single host does show notes. If it's a YouTube channel, they may not. They'll put notes inside of the description on YouTube, which you can grab content there. However, on the podcast website area where they post the episodes, you can often get some really great content. The number one thing, though, is ask the host. Don't just grab content and start putting it all over the internet. What you want to do is you want to ask permission, because they may give you added value, added information. So let me show you what show notes actually are and how you can optimize it. Okay, here I'm going to start with John Lee Dumas. John Lee Dumas is probably one of the most well-known podcasters and podcast coaches and mentors around. He's been doing this since 2012. I had the opportunity to meet him right around 2013. Fantastic guy. He's really stuck with the whole focus of becoming one of the leaders in the podcast movement, and he definitely is. You can see from his income right here, $178,218 in the month of May. Not in the whole year, in the month of May. A lot of that actually comes, as you'll notice, from sponsorships. Now, he actually shows you exactly where his money comes from. Entrepreneur on Fire sponsorships, that's about probably 54%, it says. Then from online courses, he makes about 20%. From affiliate revenue, he makes 18%, and the rest is from the journal that he sells. He's got a really nice journal that I think it's $40, but the bulk of his money comes from sponsorships. So can you make money with podcast shows? Absolutely. And yet it took him 7 years to get to this point. So don't think it's gonna happen overnight. He stuck with it, he was very clear. He really fine-tuned everything he does, and he teaches people how to do the same. But the point of this particular training is not to show you his income, even though it's pretty darn impressive. It's to show you show notes. And this is done for every single episode. Now, I can assure you that John has a team of people that actually do the work for him. His brilliance resides in doing the interviews, going out and doing speaking engagements, and being the visionary for his company. And with each episode, you'll notice there are short descriptions, but if you click on any one description, let's click on this one, Achieve Financial Freedom by Working Less and Earning More with Danny Randazzo. Okay, so we click on the link right here. This is the permalink. It goes directly to his episode page. And here we've got a little bit about Danny. We've got some resources, and we've also got who the sponsors are. On this particular episode, John really focuses on giving the sponsors a lot of traction, which means a lot of people are seeing this. Now, with somebody like John, because he gets millions upon millions of downloads, it's not that easy to get on his show nowadays. I actually interviewed him a few years ago, and at that time, he wasn't as in demand as he is now. He was pretty in demand, but now it's pretty impossible to get on his show. However, it's not impossible. But the whole point being is, take a look at these show notes. In the notes, there's a lot of great information that you can use for tweets, you can use for LinkedIn posts, you can use for Facebook, you can create a blog post out of it. Again, you want to make sure that you ask the host for permission before just taking the content. But this is a way to repurpose content so that you don't have to work as hard and you get a lot of traction from it. And now Amy Porterfield, she's another one that she has done incredibly well with podcasting. I've known Amy for probably 12 to 15 years. I've interviewed her, she's interviewed me, and she's got 269 episodes. If it's an episode a week, that's about 52 per year. So we're looking at about 5 years worth of content. Notice the common thread there. They've been doing this for a while. Don't assume that you're going to jump into one side or the other of podcasting and become an overnight success. It doesn't happen that way. My focus is on working with entrepreneurs who want to get on shows. The way to get on big shows like this is to be worthy of that opportunity, which means get on a lot of shows, get really good at what you're doing, be able to hold a great conversation, bring lots of value to the experience, don't try to sell right away, and do what you can to help promote the episode. So let's take episode 264. In this one excuse, is this one excuse? I don't have my glasses on, so I'm trying to read it. Sneaking into your business and slowing you down. Okay, so here's the episode, and notice there's lots and lots of great content here. And right here, there's a revenue generating opportunity for Amy, but we've got lots of great content right here that could be turned into a blog post, into tweets, it could be turned into a Facebook post, into LinkedIn post, whatever. But always ask the host. Don't just assume that they wouldn't mind. Always ask the host. So my encouragement to you is look for lots and lots of opportunities. When you are doing a pre-interview with the host, if they require that, ask them, do you do show notes? If they do show notes, ask them if you can get a copy of the show notes and let them know, I would like the show notes because I want to repurpose the content and give the episode as much traction and visibility as possible. The more you work with the host to promote the episode, the more likely it is that they'll tell their colleagues about you and they'll invite you back. So think long term. Don't just think short term and like, what can I do to sell something on the podcast show today? That's not what podcasts traditionally are about. Podcasts are about creating massive value. So go out, create massive value, really help the host promote the episode, and do all you can to get as much traction for your episode as possible. And if you know of other guests that the host would be a great fit for, or the guest would be a fit for the host, send them to the host, introduce them. The more you make it easy for the people you work with on all different levels, the more opportunity you create. It's all about value. This is Kathleen Gage inviting you. Subscribe to this channel. Go ahead and subscribe right now and hit the bell notification, because when you hit the bell notification, you get updates when every new episode comes out. I try to do an episode a day, Monday through Friday, short, under 10 minutes, that is very specific to getting great podcast opportunities. Another thing I'd love for you to do is like this particular video and share it with your friends. Click the link for LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook. Just spread it out there and help me to get the word out so that I create more value for the people you know. This is Kathleen Gage wishing you a great day. Go ahead and subscribe.